We're talking now about business startup. Paul, you've run a business yourself. What's it like?
Martin, it's really hard work. I mean, you've no idea how hard it is. It's a 24/7 commitment that you make. And you do get phoned up at 3 in the morning when somebody breaks into the offices. It is very, very hard work. You've got to be totally, totally committed. And I'd really therefore say that it's not for everybody. If you like the security of a monthly paycheck, if you like that check to pay the mortgage, then this isn't the sort of thing that you want to do.
For those people that do, how can they find a business idea?
Oh, many people just have that eureka moment, and wow, it comes out of the blue to them, that this idea is something for them. But actually, I do believe that you can look for a business idea in a more systematic way. It is about scanning the horizon. It is about understanding the local market that you're in and seeing whether there's an opportunity for that idea within that local market. And I think one of the things I've tried to do with the new edition of the book is to pull together that systematic process of scanning the horizon and spotting business opportunity. I think I've pulled that together in a better way than in previous editions.
And if there was one major shortcoming of the majority of business ideas, what would it be?
Oh, that's very easy. Most people who fail in business have got a product or service focus rather than a market focus. By that I mean, they love to do whatever is involved in business, but actually they don't like selling the product or the service. They don't understand the customers. They don't understand the marketplace. So, very simple answer to that one. It's a product rather than a customer focus.
And if you did have three main tips for growing a business, what would they be?
Well, following on from the previous answer, first tip, think customer. You've really got to understand who your customer is. You've really got to understand why they are buying from you as opposed to other competitors. You've really got to understand how you can convince them to buy even more from you. So first point, think customer. Second point, plan ahead. Leave nothing to chance because chance will happen to you. So as much as you plan ahead, you'll be prepared for the things that come and hit you in the face. So always plan ahead. Prepare that business plan. And remember, the process of planning is far more important than the plan itself. So think customer, plan ahead. And then the final point, don't run out of cash. Most businesses fail because they run out of cash. Bills are paid by cash, they're not paid by profit. And, well, the number of businesses that I've seen that haven't understood the difference between profit and cash flow are enormous, and they're usually the businesses that don't work.
And if you have got a good business idea, how easy is it to secure finance in the first place?
There's always been talk about a financing gap for small businesses, and certainly after the credit crunch, finance is extremely hard to get. But the reality is, if you've got a really good business idea, you will always find money to back it. The question is, what is the marketplace for that business idea?
And what are bankers looking for?
Bankers, well, owner-managers and entrepreneurs always turn to bankers first because they don't have to part with equity in the business. They don't have to lose control of their own business. But the reality is that bankers are looking for secure interest payments and a secure repayment of the capital. Bankers are not in the risk business. And if you want money that is risky money, then you've got to go to business angels or venture capitalists.
Talking of which, people will be familiar with programs like Dragon's Den. If you were a venture capitalist, a business angel, you were looking at investment, what would you be looking at? What would you be trying to assess when you're looking at a pitch?
Well, when the dragons are looking at, in the Dragon's Den, they're looking at those business pitches. I guess they're trying to assess three things, essentially. First of all, they're trying to understand the market for the product or service. They're trying to understand who the customers will be and what the value to the customers will be from that product or service, and assess evidence of need from the customers. That's the first thing. That's very important. The second thing they're trying to assess, once they've convinced themselves that there is a market for this product or service, is the profitability of the opportunity. Can the opportunity be pursued, and can they make some money out of it? Because they want a limited investment horizon, 5 years, 10 years at most, probably. And then they'll want to get their money out multiplied a number of times. So it's the profitability of the business opportunity is the second thing they're looking for. And the third thing they're looking for in that business pitch will be whether the manager, the owner-manager, the entrepreneur can actually make the opportunity happen. They'll be looking for their credibility. Do they understand the marketplace? Do they have faith that they can really reach